What's happening? I got a lot in my head, group. That's a lot, man. And it's getting high. I might have to swing it down low. I don't know, man. Anyway, man, I have a solution. Now, it's not really a solution. It was something that I've been knowing for a long time, of course, but let me put it back out on the recording about how it's easy to add things up and do multiplications, like math and everything else, like the number 9. When you, if you're doing math, right? Were you adding a number 9, right? Or any kind of number, I'm just choosing 9, because 9 just is 9 is 9. So 9 plus 8 is 17, right? I hate the fact that my eyes get red like that. 9 plus 8 is 17. 9 plus... fucking bitch talking. 9 plus 8 is 17. 9 plus 7 is 16. 9 plus... yeah, 9 plus 6 is 15. 9 plus 4 is 13. So you see, from the answer itself, right? The numbers is going down. Although one is remain, you see that the number, the last number, the second digit, that number goes down by one. So let's just say 9 plus 7. It goes down by one off the 7. So it's going to be 16. You feel me? So 9 plus 5. That's a 5. 9 plus 5 will be what, 14? Because it went down off the one that, off the second digit. So 9 is the first digit, right? The plus is neutral. Four. Then everyone, the second digit is what? Please. 9 plus, let's say 9 plus 4. So when you do the equal part, it's going to be 1 and 3. It just goes down by the second digit number. So we're going to do the, let me just go through it again for my own sake. So 9 plus 5 is 14. 9 plus 4 is 13. 9 plus 2, you got it, 11. Yes, because that's how it works. Now, how does that concept work in multiplication? Okay, we could do that. So multiplication is 9 times 1 is what? 9, yes. 9 times 2 is 18. 9 times 3 is 24. No. 9 times 3 is 24. 9 times 3 is 24. 9 times 4 is 36. 9 times 5 is 9 times 5 is 45. So 9 times 6 is 54. Yes. Because we just gonna stop at 6. So, and this is not something I just memorized. I really don't know the times table. It's just the formula. It's just the way that's how it works. So it's a 9 times 1 is what? 9. Remember the digits then, right? 9 times 2 is what? 18. 9 times 3 is what? 27. If you take a look at it, you have 9, 18 and 27. Those are the first three answers, right? What's the common denominator in all in them? You have the same thing. You got 9, then the next number is 18, right? Boom. So the number that is going up, 9 went up, it's from 9 it went to 8, then from 8 it went to 7, which is the second digit, and the first digit just went up by, first it was 09, then 18, then it became 1, then 2, 3. You see, that's how it's working. So I'm gonna do it again, then I'm explaining it again to y'all. So you got 9 times 1 is 9. 9 times 2 is 18. 9 times 3 is what 27. You see how that shit keep climbing? Yes, that's how it went. I always fuck up at 9 times 3. I feel like it should be, but it's true. So 9 times 3 is 27, right? 9 times 4, you got it, 45. No, it's 36. 9 times 5 is 45. Then 9 times 6 is 54. You feel me? So that's how it goes. So you have 9, 18, 27, 27, 36. So you see this, the first digit is going up. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the second digit, which is, it started off on 18. So it went up 8. Then the next number will be 27. So you see, one is moving up. One is moving up. The first line is moving up. The second line is dropping. And that's how it works throughout the whole nine. That's how numbers work in period. If you take a look at the answers very, very carefully, you get to see that. That's why you have a number like, people are looking at the difference in the number. They're like, nine, all you gotta do just count nine numbers. From 9 plus 9 will be 18. And I'm like, there's a much easier way. There's no need for counting. The answer is just right there. It's just 9, 18, 27, 36, 45, 54, 63. You see how it goes? It just keep going. I gotta go.